Hello, this is Echo and Clock.
And Ripper95, a.k.a. Cool Guy 902.
Welcoming you to the very last episode of Let's Play Jak and Daxter.
Because apparently EC here doesn't like me being in his videos.
That's not true.
Yeah, I see.
I had a lot of fun up until the last couple episodes where you're inviting people I didn't like.
Okay, that was your fault that you didn't like them, but that was pretty damn funny.
Yeah.
If you people know what we're referencing now, then you're... Then there shouldn't be. You shouldn't realize what we're talking about unless I did a job right.
All right. So regardless, that just left without. That just left without me.
Haha. Oh, you're a nerd.
So if it does leave without you, it sometimes does. Apparently, there's really all you can do except for jump. But it'll come right back. So it'll bring you back up. So you already saw like how the game ends and everything.
Yep. And this is basically what happens afterwards. There's still nothing glowing and you can't go through that goddamn door. Just being left out as a kid.
So, let's just come over here. As you can see, this is the highest point. Snowy Mountain's right there, it's pretty low. It looks like there, over there.
Looks like there's Aurora Borealis going on all over the place. Yeah.
That's a Green Sage Hut, probably.
Probably.
This is right there.
Yeah, that makes sense.
That's probably like where the Precursor city is. That's where like Missy Island's probably. Let's quickly go down here.
I really wish that they was it, because the sequel it takes no place near here.
Yeah.
So I kind of wish that they had made a sequel that kind of took place in the other parts of this area that we never got to explore. But
so,
as we promised earlier, here's Russell screwing up again. But as we promised earlier, we were going to have like a reunion like special. And we were going to show how the world didn't really change after you saved everybody.
It's still the same world. And that's an elevator. Still just going up and down. It's like you press one, but then you realize you want to press three again. But then you press one again as soon as you get to three.
That made no sense.
Elevator.
So did you tell them about how this area used to be the bane of your existence as a small child? Because you would always miss one of the scout flies in here.
Yeah, it's usually the just a random one, but like I've never gotten it one sweep. So
the one that I missed, I missed one here too, and it was the one that was right next to this door.
Wow.
So I had to jump off the top of the area right there and navigate my way down here.
So one thing I'd like to point out is
something that I didn't even know about. I've been showing a whole lot of things to EC here that he didn't know.
There's actually a whole secret area in the lava tube that really no one knows about.
Well, I'm sure some people know.
I'm sure a good amount of people, but like not a lot of people know about it. Because it's like just an area that looks like if you try to explore it, you'll end up dying a molten death.
Yay, molten death.
So you know what, for the sake of it, this is like a finale episode. I'm not going to go the way I usually go with lava tube. I'm going to ride these carts. Just to relax, watch the lava sort of splatter.
This really doesn't seem safe. I just realized how unsafe these minecarts are. There's not really even minecarts, they're just trays with wheels.
And horns on each side.
Why are there horns? Do they expect to be in a battle or something?
Battle carts. They're battle carts.
Oh god. Battle toad carts?
Ha! So, what you gotta do is you gotta just jump right in here. And... Yeah, you'll see it pretty soon. Pick up this balloon.
And you want to have a relatively cool temperature for when you get to this area.
Because it's pretty hot. But there it is right there. Just jump right on in. It's a whole secret area.
Now, the thing is, you heat up really fast because you're over open lava and you see guys. But that's the only secret area. But you want to make sure you always catch those balloons, right, EC?
That's right. And, yeah, I should have just drove off the cliff. What you're supposed to do is when you get to the end, you're supposed to jump, which I didn't do, which is why I died.
Yep.
So, next, I'd like to revisit Sandover Village.
And just show how things haven't really changed that much, even though you would expect them to a little.
The Snowy Mountain and the Spider Cave are pretty much the same. And I would show you, but, like...
I would murder him.
Yeah.
Now, the thing that I always kind of wish that they had done in this was that... Like, in Silent Hill and everything, when you beat the game, or, like, with even Resident Evil, when you beat the game, you get the ability to go back and do it again on a harder difficulty.
Yeah. And that's something they introduced in the later games, but not this one.
Really? They introduced that in later games?
It was in 2. It was a hero mode.
I never knew that. I never got that. Oh. Well, that's because I never really beat the last boss in it.
Yeah. Well,
the last boss, just an FYI, the last boss in the... And the second game is ridiculous. It's easier than the last boss in the third game.
Yeah.
No, it's harder than the last boss in the third game. The last boss in the third game is easier. And Samos will always appear to stay in Golemaya's Citadel.
Really?
Yeah, because he wasn't there. He's not in his house.
I didn't see him in the Citadel either, though.
Maybe they just kind of disappear from the map.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I figure. I mean, like, none of the sages are there anymore, and Kira is missing. Maybe they're all inside that door. Like, they just got closing the door. So, come over to the beach. There's still Blue Eagle all over the place. There's still these crates here. The windmills are still flowing. There's still lurker crabs here.
But there's still lurker snakes, but I don't think the lurker... Yeah, I don't think the normal lurkers are going to respawn.
Yeah, the lurker...
Launchers.
Yeah, the lurker launchers, since they were canonical to the... Collection.
Canonical.
They were canon to the collecting of one of the power cells. So, like, the destroying of one of them gets you a power cell, so it's not going to ever come back.
Okay.
So, yeah, the beach is pretty much always going to be the same. It's just the beach. It's got a nice view of everything. Like, you can see Misty Island in the distance to the right. You could, from the beach, you could probably, like, see... Like, the top of the Green Sage's hut, you probably wouldn't be able to see. Come around here. It's all the same. The farmer still lives on a beach farm. Herding his yak out in his sleep. The Oracle's still gonna be up there. He's precursor metal, he's not going anywhere.
That stuff's heavy.
Yeah. Hey, even though I'm carrying like 470. And I still haven't been able to figure out what the significance of the 470 orbs that you have at the end are.
Yeah, I mean, it might just be a random number that they had left over, but I was hoping that it would have some significance to everything. 47 years till the sequel comes out, which is what it felt like.
Yeah. Even though it was only like, not that many years. If you look up here at the right angle, like, it's floating. It's like, how is it even being held up there? Piranhas are still there.
I wonder how the precursors did all that. Because even if the precursors were the size of this guy, that's still a lot of heavy metal.
Yeah.
I mean, the molten lava can't even melt most precursor metal.
That's true. That fisherman is kind of creeping me out. Is he still laughing
at something?
I think he really likes fish. I mean, I imagine that's why his profession is fisherman.
Like, he's that's why his name is Fisherman as well.
Yeah, he just loves fish. It just cracks him up.
Just like the sculptor, his name is the sculptor.
Yeah. I don't think the sculptor's ever going to get much done with that rock. Especially since the muse is sitting on top of it. Wake up, farmer. I wonder if he's sick. If, like, he has like some sort of like illness, and that's why he's so asleep all the time.
What's that disease where you just fall asleep at random moments? Maybe he has that.
Yeah, the eagle beam still collected, the windmill still flowing. And this damn mayor still hasn't fixed his bow tie. I'm not voting for him.
It kind of sucks that you can't re-talk to any of these people.
The uncle that said he would be going on a trip, he's still here. He's not going anywhere.
One fact, the map that he has in his room, if you get the guidebook for on this game, the same map is in the book.
Oh, that's fantastic. So yeah, he's either going to hit his hand eventually or like have to move the muse. In which I'll probably have to revisit
Misty Island
once again. And how did he even get over there?
Maybe he hitched a ride on our boat and never came back.
Wake up, farmer man! Wake up! I feel bad for him. But, see, that's that. There's a windmill right next to the Green Sage's hut. pretty safe. There's the two fishermen's boats, the one that was wrecked and the one that still works fine.
And here's us deciding where we're gonna go next.
Yeah. So next we're gonna go over the Blue Sage's hut and revisit that. Because, yeah, the best area in the game was connected to the Blue Sage's hut, the Lost Precursor City. Probably my favorite area in this game. It's pre-selected, convenient.
I think it always does that. Like, it always goes for the next area.
But... yeah. So, there's a lot of waterfalls on this side, which is kind of neat. Yeah, there's the Lost Precursor City. There's the entrance to the Boggy Swamp. Blue Eco Beam still holding up a rock over there.
The rocks still haven't been extinguished. I think the Blue Sage should really get a hold on this. I also haven't noticed that all of their huts are shaped like buckets.
Yeah, they really are. And one thing I don't know if I'm pretty sure I pointed out in the last video, but all the sages are like their skin is dyed with the eco that they work with. Like the Blue Sage has like a bluish skin, the Green Sage has a greenish skin.
The Red Sage is pretty badass.
Yeah. And the Yellow Sage wanted to make soup out of Daxter.
There's which precursor. I think would have been very tasty.
Yeah. There's a Precursor base and it still has like a huge thing of metal. The lightning bowls, if you go in there, they're still there. In here, there's the Gambler. He's still in a barrel. Fallen Hero still crying.
Even though we won.
Even though we beat the monster.
I think he's crying because now he looks stupid.
Here's the bane of my existence right here.
And mine.
Another Oracle.
Oracle man just like, what up, Hada?
I wonder if the power cell is his life force, and like by trading, he's like, oh, I can't talk anymore, and that's why you can't talk to
me. Oh, I never noticed that waterfall directly underneath this hut.
That's actually a very beautiful waterfall.
There's like a huge like, little lake underneath it. Oh, there's Flut Flut.
And Flut Flut's right there. Hey, Flut Flut. So...
and there's the Precursor City stills. Not going anywhere. There's the chamber that we raised, though. We could move that around if we felt like it.
And you can just move that back up and down. So, yeah, this area is like that.
I'm kind of disappointed that it didn't really change anything after the game, but, I mean, for all intents and purposes, it was a pretty big game.
Yeah. I mean, the fact that it's such a seamless 3D game, there's, like, so much to explore.
And to have full circle. Start at the game where we started the game.
Yep. Let's hop over to Geyser Rock. And just to, like, walk through it, I mean, now that there's no more interruptible scenes. I can just dash right on through this.
You could actually time him to see how long it takes him to fail. We should issue a challenge to our viewers to upload as a video response to see how fast they can get through this whole area after they've beaten the game so they don't have to go through the cutscenes.
Yeah.
How fast they could beat this area and take out all of the target monsters.
Yeah. I'd like to see that. Like, if someone who's watching this would like to do that, I'd really love to see that. So yeah, that door's never going to be closed. There's still geysers all over the place. It's actually a very beautiful area.
I have to say, for the time this game came out, the graphics were pretty good.
Yeah.
I mean, it was pretty easily trumped by the games that came out afterwards, but... for the time when it came out, it was pretty good.
So... and what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna just be a badass right here. I'm just gonna.
Whoa, watch out, guys. We're dealing with a badass over here.
So, in the second episode, I promised I'd make this my house. So, like, in retrospect, I'm just gonna end the video here. Watch the geysers go off. There's a geyser up above me. So,
this has been Ripper95, aka CoolGuy902.
And Echoing Clock.
And we'll see you next time in Let's Play Jak and Daxter 2.
Thank you for watching.
See ya.